Trent, I can't believe this day is finally here, and I'm so excited to take your hand in marriage. It's funny I say this now, because 4 years ago, if you asked me what I thought of marriage, I probably would have responded with fear. You know me better than anyone, and you know that fear has been one of my closest companions for all of my life. And when I became an adult, I thought the monsters under my bed would disappear, but they didn't. And if you asked me about marriage 4 years ago, I would have responded that it's scary. Marriage is a terrifying thing.
The Bible talks of perfect love casting out all fear. I can't love you perfectly and may fail miserably at points. But I will love you fiercely, vulnerably, and honestly with everything that I have. I will field your fears and do my best to love you with patience and kindness. Our love hasn't been a walk in the park. In my mind, it's been an adventurous journey through a beautiful garden. A journey with no end in sight. I'm the luckiest guy on earth to take on this adventure of life next to you.
Today, though, I have a new song on my tongue. Today, the fear is still there. I see it in the corner, but I see something different beside it.
Oh my gosh. Beautiful.
Oh my god.
You look gorgeous.
Look at you. Pretty bright.
Trent, next to you, I see the fullness of life, the beauty of breath, the sanctity of fellowship, and I want to say yes to it all. The monsters under the bed are not magically gone, and the world is not suddenly a safe place. There's new courage. And I think a lot of that has to do with me and you. Trent, you live fully, not absent-minded to the fear, but in fierce opposition to it.
Our Father, love has been your richest and greatest gift to the world. Love that matures into marriage is one of your greatest creations. Today we celebrate this kind of love as it manifests itself with Kaitlyn and Trent. I encourage both of you to have a marriage that's alive, to grow it, to change it, to maintain the capacity of wonder, spontaneity, humor, to remain pliable, warm, sensitive. I encourage you to fully and always show your real feelings, to save time for each other, nurture each other to fullness and wholeness.
I promise, with Christ as our foundation, to honor, cherish, and respect you throughout our marriage, choosing to be faithful to you and you alone.
I promise to pursue the Lord alongside you in our marriage and to make him known in our pursuits as a team.
I promise to pursue joy, laughter, and fun together, knowing our days here are numbered. On harder days, I promise to stay actively engaged in our marriage
and find new ways to appreciate and love you more fully with each passing day.
Kaitlyn and Trent have both agreed to share the rest of their lives together. You have symbolized your commitment by exchanging rings. You may kiss the bride.
We're married!
It's my privilege to be the first to introduce you to Mr. and Mrs. Trent and Kaitlyn Ward.
You and Kaitlyn are amazing people that deserve nothing less than a lifetime of love and happiness.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Kaitlyn and Trent!
as you begin this lifelong adventure. And for you too, it's gonna be an adventure. Remember that you're always on the same team.
I remember Trent and I as kids playing in the backyard, daydreaming about the names of our future wives. This daydreaming has now materialized in the form of Trent sitting across from me in the same room with the woman of his dreams.
Trent is so perfect for Kaitlyn because she now has round-the-clock access to a first responder at all times.
May you always love each other unconditionally. May you always love the Lord with all your heart. And may you always love each other. Cheers.